Did you know that we can either positively or negatively affect our DNA based purely upon the quality of our thoughts and emotions? Many people believe that the DNA with which we are born is the sole determinant for who we are and will become. However, science is showing that we're not simply victims of our genes. Renowned cell biologist Bruce Lipton says the new science of epigenetics emphasizes that the environment, and more importantly, our perceptions of the environment, control our gene activity. But epigenetics is not only about our DNA, where we live, and all the twists, turns, and hard knocks of our lives. Researchers suggest that our internal environment, the thoughts, feelings, and intentions we have every day, is highly impactful on our health and well-being. Modern studies have shown that positive emotional intervention practices, and especially emotions such as love, joy, and gratitude, increase the activity of genes involved in the production of cytokines, which are proteins that help to regulate the immune system and fight off infections, while also decreasing the expression of genes associated with inflammation. A study by Fredrickson et al. Also showed that our genes are highly sensitive to the quality of our positive emotions. When we have experiences that produce more meaningful fulfillment, such as activities that are in alignment with our deeper purpose, or doing something kind for someone, it causes the genes associated with our stress response to downregulate, which has been shown to lead to better health outcomes and improved immune function. Whereas more fleeting experiences of pleasure, such as watching a fun movie or getting a great deal, did not produce these same benefits. Early research from the HeartMath Institute hinted at this critical role that genuine heart-centered emotions play in our physiology, with one pivotal addition. The researchers posited, can physical aspects of DNA strands be influenced by heart-focused intention? They tested their theory and found the answer to be yes, if the person is in a state of heart coherence. The study consisted of two groups of individuals. The experimental group, who were experienced in heart coherence practices, and a control group who were not. All participants were instructed to self-generate feelings of love and appreciation while holding the intention to cause a sample of DNA to either wind or unwind. During the trials, researchers observed that the control group displayed no increase in their heart coherence levels and also produced no change in the DNA. However, when the researchers studied the experimental group, they witnessed a distinct increase in their heart coherence levels, as well as significant changes in the DNA strands. Many different variations were tested, and it was concluded that the combination of high ratios of heart coherence plus genuine intention produced the most marked effects on the DNA. This is a really exciting finding, as heart coherence is something we can all practice as we move through our daily lives. Its power lies in combining heart-focused breathing while intentionally creating a beneficial emotional state, like gratitude, compassionate care, or hope. With genuine intention and a little practice, we really do have the capacity to influence our own bodies, our health, and experience of life for the better.